I did not serve in the military, but my 81-year-old father did. He was an Air Force veteran stationed in Germany during the height of the Cold War in the late 1950s. He was a teenager from inner city Newark, a stranger in a foreign land, serving on the western side of the Berlin Wall. My dad proudly wore the uniform because he swore an oath to the Constitution and believed in American democracy. I believe in American democracy. We remain the last best hope on earth. It is in that spirit that we proceed today. Professor Karlan, in America, we believe in free and fair elections. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
But authoritarian regimes do not. Is that right?
That's correct.
Thomas Jefferson once wrote, or John Adams once wrote to Thomas Jefferson on December 6, 1787, and stated, "You are apprehensive of foreign interference, intrigue, influence. So am I. But as often as elections happen, the danger of foreign influence recurs." Professor Karlan, how important was the concept of free and fair elections to the framers of the Constitution?
Honestly, it was less important to them than it's become in our Constitution since then. And if you'll remember, one of the things that turned me into a lawyer was seeing Barbara Jordan, who was the first female lawyer I'd ever seen in practice, say on the committee that we, the people, didn't include people like her in 1789, but through a process of amendment, we have done that. And so elections are more important to us today as a constitutional matter than they were even to the framers.
And is it fair to say that an election cannot be reasonably characterized as free and fair if it's manipulated by foreign interference?
That's correct.
And the framers of the Constitution were generally and deeply concerned with the threat of foreign interference in the domestic affairs of the United States, true?
Yes.
And why were they so deeply concerned?
Because foreign nations don't have our interests at heart. They have their interests at heart.
And would the framers find it acceptable for an American president to pressure a foreign government to help him win an election?
I think they'd find it unacceptable for a president to ask a foreign government to help him, whether they put pressure on him or not.
Direct evidence shows that on a July 25th phone call, the president uttered five words: "Do us a favor, though." He pressured the Ukrainian government to target an American citizen for political gain, and at the same time, simultaneously withheld $391 million in military aid. Now, Ambassador Bill Taylor, West Point graduate, Vietnam War hero, Republican-appointed diplomat, discussed this issue of military aid. Here is a clip of his testimony.
Again, our holding up of security assistance that would go to a country that is fighting aggression from Russia for no good policy reason, no good substantive reason, no good national security reason is wrong.
To the extent the military aid was being withheld as part of an effort to solicit foreign interference in the 2020 election, is that behavior impeachable?
Yes, it is. And if I could go back to one of the words you read, when the president said, "Do us a favor," he was using the royal we there. It wasn't a favor for the United States. He should have said, "Do me a favor," because only kings say us when they mean me.
And is it correct that an abuse of power that strikes at the heart of our democracy falls squarely within the definition of a high crime and misdemeanor?
Yes, it does.
Some of my colleagues have suggested that impeachment would overturn the will of the people. The American people expressed their will in November of 2018. The will of the people elected a new majority. The will of the people elected a House that would not function as a wholly owned subsidiary of this administration. The will of the people elected a House that understands we are a separate and co-equal branch of government. The will of the people elected a House that understands we have a constitutional responsibility to serve as a check and balance on an out-of-control executive branch. The president abused his power and must be held accountable. No one is above the law. America must remain the last best hope on earth. I yield back.